So welcome to our channel of Sciences and Mathematics. I'm Ernest. Today we're going to look at the concept of trying to find the divergency. And we have already discussed about the concept of finding the gradient. So today we're going to look at the concept of finding a divergency and see the difference between what we have already worked under this concept of a vector vector differentiation. So for that case, thank you and welcome. So in trying to figure out how we can be able to describe divergency given this specific information, so from our sample question, we have been told find the divergence of A given phi is equals x squared y z cubed, and the vector A is equals x z I minus y squared j plus 2x squared y. Okay, so from that one, we have already discussed how now we can be able to represent divergency from our previous video. So a divergence is given as del dot A, and this one can be given as I x. So this basically is I, so this is y j, so this j, and then plus z k dot. Now for the vector components of A, we're going to represent it using the one that we have been given, which is going to be this is x z I minus y squared j plus 2x squared k, and the dot product of those specific vectors are going to give us a scalar. So therefore, we're going to have to multiply the corresponding components for I, j, and k. And this is going to give us, so this section of del multiplied by the first one is going to give us del for x component xz plus del for the y component. This is going to be a negative value. I've just given this one intentionally to indicate that specific presence for the negative value, plus for the z component is going to be this one and this one, basically, which is going to be 2x squared, and this is going to be a differentiation of this specific part of the I component with respect to x. It's going to give us z. Since the differential for maybe a derivative of x is going to be 1. So for the second one, it's going to be differentiating well with respect to that specific part is going to give us 2y, but a negative one, so it is going to be negative 2y. So for the z component, it's going to be a differentiation with respect to z. Now this one does not have the z component, therefore it's going to be 0. So therefore, our equation for finding the divergency of A is going to give us z minus 2y. So basically, this is how we perform that one. By first doing the dot product from the basic properties of a dot product, as I said, we have this one represented as, which is equivalent. That one makes the vectors, the aspect of the vectors disappear. So therefore, this is going to be a scalar quantity, which is going to be represented as z minus 2y for the divergency of that one. So basically, this is how we can be able to use, we can be able to use the similar procedure in treating some of the equations that we may be given and being asked to find the divergence. So I think we've already seen, and we're going to apply the same in case we come across some of the equations that are being represented as this. So that is for today, guys. By God bless.